Myself, Dr. W. P. Ganole from Kamalabai Mahavidyalaya, Nagpur. Today I am going to discuss on the topic carbohydrate, and here we are going to see the what is carbohydrate, classification of carbohydrate into monosaccharide, oligosaccharides and then polysaccharides, and after that we are going to see the important reactions of the monomer, that is monosaccharide glucose. So today's topic is carbohydrate, and here first of all we are going to see what do you mean by the carbohydrate. And we know that carbohydrate are naturally occurring organic compound which contain carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. They constitute the part of food we eat and provide most of the energy that keeps the human engine running. Carbohydrate are widely spread in a plant. Cellulose is the structural material of plant and is made up of only glucose unit. They provide raw material for many industries like textile, paper, rayon, fermentation, explosive, etc. like that. And carbohydrate is regarded as a hydrates of carbon because their molecular formula in many cases correspond to CH2O Y. X and Y are the integer, and therefore example of such type of compound is a glucose, cane sugar are the example of this type. And here the carbohydrate is a substance which yield carbon when treatment with the concept H2SO4, when heated strongly they give they regarded as a hydrates of carbon, and therefore it is known as carbohydrate. The carbohydrate are polyfunctional compound. They also contain the functional group like alcoholic hydroxy group, aldehyde group and ketonic group. And as we know, carbohydrate can be defined as polyhydroxyaldehyde or polyhydroxyketone, and large molecule that produce this compound on the hydrolysis and contain at least one asymmetric carbon atom. So this is the definition of carbohydrate. So it can be defined as the polyhydroxyaldehyde or polyhydroxyketone, and these molecules are obtained on the hydrolysis and contain at least one asymmetric carbon atom. So after this, now we are going to see the classification of carbohydrate in the next slide. So mainly carbohydrates are classified into two parts, sugar and non-sugar. And here sugar can be further classified into, so here sugar and non-sugar. Sugars are monosaccharide and oligosaccharides. In case of monosaccharide, aldehyde ketones are there. In case of non-sugar, polysaccharides. So this is the different types. Carbohydrate is divided into two parts, sugar and non-sugar. So here now we are going to see, so we can say that carbohydrates are classified into two main groups, that is sugar and non-sugar. And first part is a sugar. And what is sugar? Now the sugar are carbohydrate which are sweet to taste, soluble in water and crystalline in nature. Sugar are further subdivided into two parts. One is a monosaccharides and oligosaccharides. So what is now monosaccharides? These are the simple sugar which could not be hydrolyzed further. These are optically active. Polyhydroxyaldehyde and ketones. And monosaccharides are also known as aldose or ketose, depending upon the type of carbonyl group present. They are further also classified into tetrose, pentose, like that, on the basis of number of carbon atoms present in the monosaccharides. For example, here is shown here monosaccharides. So here in this slide it shows that glucose does not go under hydrolysis and no reactions is taking place. And here there are large number of structural and stereoisomer having the formula C6H12O6, of which glucose and fructose are the most important compounds. And in the next slide we are going to see second part, that is oligosaccharides. These are the sugar which can undergo hydrolysis and give 2 to 10 molecules of simple sugar, that is monosaccharides. Oligosaccharides are further classified depending on the number of monosaccharide molecules which they give on the hydrolysis. So for example, disaccharides, and these are the sugar with formula C12H22O11, which on hydrolysis give two molecules of monosaccharides. For example, sucrose, maltose, lactose. And here sucrose give two molecules shown here in this slide. Sucrose is the formula. When it hydrolyzes in presence of acid, we get two molecules of monosaccharide, glucose and fructose. Similarly, raffinase also give undergo hydrolysis and forming three molecules of monosaccharide, glucose, fructose and galactose. So here they give two. So this is the example of trisaccharide raffinase. So trisaccharides, these are the sugar having molecular formula C18H32O16. On hydrolysis they give three molecules of monosaccharides. An example is raffinase shown in this slide. And raffinase undergo hydrolysis forming three monosaccharides. So one is glucose, fructose and galactose. Formula is same. Similarly, there are tetrasaccharides. Formula is C24H42O21. And also pentasaccharides C30H52O26, like that. So these are second oligosaccharides. And now next slide we are going to see what is polysaccharides, that is non-sugar. These are the carbohydrates which are not sweet to taste and insoluble in water. These carbohydrates are hydrolyzable and on hydrolysis give large number of monosaccharide molecules. They are naturally occurring polymers of monosaccharides. An example of this type is a starch, cellulose, inulin, etc. And so here starch undergo hydrolysis and give n number, because we have taken n time. So n times, what is, we get the monosaccharide glucose molecule. So starch undergo hydrolysis and give large number of monosaccharide molecule. So it is shown here. And so this is the polysaccharide also, which give only one type of monosaccharide on hydrolysis, then it is known as homopolysaccharides. And if it give two or more types of monosaccharides, then it is also known as heteropolysaccharides. So starch is a homopolysaccharides and it gives large number of glucose molecule only. So here glucose is also aldohexose or aldoketones. So here these are the examples of polysaccharides. So this is the classification. We can divide into sugar and non-sugar. Sugars are two, monosaccharide and oligosaccharide, and polysaccharides are the non-sugar. And after that we are going to see some important chemical reactions of the compound, that is glucose. So important reactions of glucose, one by one we are going to see here the reactions of this glucose. And first reaction of glucose shown here, that is, first of all we are going to see the reactions of free aldehyde group. So here it is shown that first reaction with hydrogen cyanide. So reaction with hydrogen cyanide, HCl. So it undergo reaction and forming the compound. So this is the glucose, this is the aldehyde group, and reaction with addition can take place. Hydrogen cyanide get added here. So here CH2OCH4, and here this CH OH CH OH and Cl. So in this way addition takes place in a reaction with aldehyde group, and we get glucose is converted to glucose cyanohydrin. So this is a simple addition reaction. And second reaction is that reaction with hydroxylamine, NH2OH. So here when molecule of hydroxylamine adds in the glucose, then it gives the corresponding oxygen with the loss of one water molecule. So here simple reaction, addition is there. So again now here this is the aldehyde group, and this H2 from this hydroxylamine and O replace, and NOH get joined here, and we get glucose oxygen compound. So this is also another addition reaction. And here after that, next reaction shown here is a third reaction with phenyl hydroxide. Now here A, B, C, three different ways are there. So in this case, glucose when react with phenyl hydroxide, it first give phenyl hydroxide. With excess of phenyl hydroxide, it gives yellow crystalline water insoluble product, which is known as OSHZone. So here, see the reaction. It is shown here. And in case of first glucose, react with this phenyl hydroxide, water get replaced, and this group join here. So one water is replaced here. And this second, this compound is taken here now, phenyl hydroxide of glucose. And react with another molecule of phenyl hydroxide, and then in this way the oxidation take place, and now here this CO group is here, and we get this type of ketonic compound of glucose phenyl hydroxide first, and after that also in the third step this undergo oxidized compound further undergo condensation reaction with third molecule. So this is third phenyl hydroxide, again water get replaced, H2NO, and this group joined here, and water get replaced and forming OSHZone. So these are the three steps in the formation of OSHZone. So depending upon that, when we take one, then it form phenyl hydroxide, and when we take excess in phenyl hydroxide, then it gives the OSHZone. So the third reaction, and fourth reaction is the oxidation. And in case of oxidation, three different conditions are there for oxidation. And first number one reaction shown, that is the glucose oxidation with mild oxidizing agent like bromine, water gives gluconic acid. So simple oxidation is there. This is the oxidizing agent, give oxygen, natural oxygen, so aldehyde group is converted to carboxylic acid group, and we get glucose is converted to the gluconic acid. So aldehyde group undergo oxidation and become carboxylic acid group and forming gluconic acid. In the second, glucose when react with the dilute nitric acid, give the saccharic acid. So here again now here oxidation take place, and now here this is the oxidizing agent, and aldehyde group again now converting to, now in this case both the aldehyde group and this group also undergo oxidation and forming this here COH group, and here also water is replaced and COH group we get. So in this way we obtain the saccharic acid. And in third, when glucose reacts with the concentrated nitric acid, it is oxidized to oxalic acid. So it's shown here, this group is converted into oxalic acid and some other compounds are formed. So these are the different conditions, whether the oxidation take place by using oxidizing agent, whether it is mild, dilute or concentrated, according to that we get different product. And number five is the reaction of this compound, what is the glucose, and reduction shows that glucose with mild reducing agent, sodium amalgam and water, aqueous sodium borohydride reduces itself and to form sorbitol and hexahydric alcohol. So sorbitol, this is the first reaction of reduction, and also another is there in which we get ion hexane. So in this case of reduction reaction, aldehyde when undergo reduction with natural hydrogen, this is the reducing agent, and what is now we get CH2OH. So here are the CHO and now CH2OH, 2H is added CH2OH, and we get this is the compound which is known as sorbitol. And after that second is the reaction we showed the reduction of this compound, and here, so second reaction of reduction shows that on heating this strong reducing agent like HI and at temperature 100 degrees Celsius in presence of red phosphorus, glucose first produces 2-iodohexane and then it gives the hexane. So here the reaction is shown. So glucose undergo this reducing agent HI, hydroiodic acid and in presence of phosphorus at temperature, this is the first it formed the iodohexane, and after further reduction we get this is the this group is added and CH2 is there, and become we get a hexane, N-hexane molecule. So in this way we obtain these compound of reduction. So in case of first sorbitol, second N-hexane are the product. Now we are going to see the second part, reaction of alcoholic group, and here first is the acetylation We have seen up to this the reaction with aldehyde group, now reaction with alcoholic group, and first is the acetylation. So here glucose when heated with acetic anhydride and give pentaacetic derivative which is known as glucose pentaacetate. So here is the reaction shown and compound formed. So this is the aldehyde glucose and this is acetic anhydride. So in this case acetyl group CH3CO group get attached here in place of H. Now acetyl group comes here. Here is also so 5. 4 are here and 1 is here, 5, and 5 acetic acid CH3COO and H. So comes here and forming this type of compound. This is acetic acid and this is glucose pentaacetate. So this is the acetylation reaction with acetic anhydride forming glucose pentaacetate. Another reaction is that reaction with calcium hydroxide, and here reaction shows that when glucose react with calcium hydroxide then it forms calcium glucosate. So here the reaction is shown that this is the calcium glucosate. So this is aldehyde glucose and here calcium hydroxide CaOH twice. So OH from this and H get replaced and we obtain this type of compound which is known as calcium glucosate. And next reaction is reaction with HCl, and here the reaction shows that glucose will react with HCl, that is a hydrochloric acid, then it forms the different compound. And here the reaction with HCl forms and give the products here, that glucose when strongly heated with HCl give the lauric acid. So here this is the, and formic acid is also formed. So this is the glucose when they have HCl forming this lauric acid, and formic acid is formed. And this formation of this acid may take place through the formation of 5-hydroxymethylfurfural, as it also forms from glucose and can convert into lauric acid. So this is the how it is formed is shown here by the process. And so this is the reaction with HCl. And important reaction after this is the that is reaction with alkali, and glucose on boiling with aqueous alkali give the mixture of glucose, fructose and mannose. So when glucose react with the alkali, then it forms the mixture of three component: glucose, mannose and fructose. So this is simple reaction. And after this now we are going to see the next important reaction, number 10, and that is fermentation. And fermentation reaction shows that here glucose when undergo the reaction in the presence of the catalyst, what is the, in presence of enzyme zymage, it is converted into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide gas is formed. So this is glucose, this is the enzyme zymage and forming ethyl alcohol and CO2. So this is also reaction, and important reaction of this glucose are the two important reaction, and two are the what is the Fehling solution test, and second is the tolerance test. And as we know that this is the reducing properties, and glucose can be easily oxidized to gluconic acid due to the presence of aldehyde group. Therefore glucose can act as a good reducing agent. It gives the following typical reducing reaction, and these two are the important reaction. And first is a Fehling solution test, and in case of Fehling solution test, Fehling A is a solution of copper sulfate, Fehling B is a solution of sodium potassium tartrate in sodium hydroxide. Fehling solution is prepared by mixing solution A and solution B. When the solution A and B are mixed, a blue color PPT of copper hydroxide is formed, which on heating give the black PPT of cupric, red precipitate of cupric oxide. It gives the black PPT of cupric oxide, that is CuO, and further heating with the glucose it gives the red precipitate of cuprous oxide, Cu2O. So it is shown in this slide that this is solution A and solution B forming the blue precipitate when it heated black precipitate of cuprous oxide and then again heated then it will get the cuprous oxide red precipitate. So in this way this is the reaction glucose when react with the copper and we get this type of this is the glucolic acid is formed one oxygen is added so CHO group is converted to carboxylic acid group and glucolic acid is formed and red precipitate of cuprous oxide is formed and the second is a tolerance reagent test and in this case also this test is also known as silver mirror test. So tolerance reagent is an ammonical solution of silver nitrate. On heating with the glucose, it gives the fine deposit of metallic silver on the side of the test tube and to form silver mirror. The silver oxide in the solution is reduced to metallic silver while glucose is oxidized to glucolic acid. So here it is shown that in the slide that glucose is converted to glucolic acid and silver oxide is converted to metallic silver. So oxygen comes here and forming glucolic acid and two Ags, two silver mirror. So this is the these are the two important reactions of this glucose and these tests are also used to test whether the glucose is present, test for the glucose. And after this now we are going to see the mechanism for oxygen formation and already we have seen three molecules of phenyl hydrazine is added. So in this way the mechanism is there. So glucose when phenyl hydrazine first molecule is added. So here in this way it is added here and we can rearrange in this way and this can also be shown in this way also here and another second. So these are the 1, 2, 3 are the rearrangement and after this rearrangement what is now another second molecule is added here and here second molecule is added phenyl hydrazine water get in place and this can be rearranged and another third molecule is added in this compound and we obtain this oxygen. So one by one the phenyl hydrazine molecule 1, 2, 3 are added in the glucose molecule 1, molecule 2, molecule 3 and we get finally the oxygen. So this is stepwise mechanism of the formation of oxygen. So today we have seen what is carbohydrate, different types of carbohydrate and their examples and classification of carbohydrate into sugar and non-sugar. That is sugars are monosaccharides and oligosaccharides and non-sugars are polysaccharides. After that we have seen some important chemical reactions of glucose.